University, and my topic is child soldiers. Most specifically, my question is, what can be done to help child soldiers from their depression? Yeah, you should argue. In order to help a child soldier, we must first break down a child soldier. What a child soldier is, it's very self-explanatory, but a child soldier is basically a child who was forced into armed forces or given to armed forces or even just manipulated into becoming a child soldier. And since 2001, child soldiers have been illegal, but they are still being used in armed forces. There is an estimate of about hundreds of thousands of child soldiers still to this day, even 18 years after it was pronounced illegal. And children as young as 8 years old are now child soldiers. You can see even here how young this child is. Can't be more than 12, but holding an assault rifle, walking next to older men, fully developed, I believe, and ready for battle. Now for some context on child soldiers. Child soldiers are more often used as frontline during battle. They're usually ahead of the main group troops and used as distractions, used as, they even, if a troop were to be ambushed, the children would die first because they're in the front. That would allow the adults to gather themselves and fight back, retaliate. And children are used in war because in war, you're trained to kill all your enemies, but because you are human, you don't want to kill a child. And as soon as you see an innocent face, you will hesitate. And that child is trained to kill you, so he won't hesitate. But you will, and that's manipulative alone without even you having to kill the child. Oh no, that doesn't make sense. But if brainwash fails, they or a family member is threatened, and the child is then pressured into becoming a child soldier, or the family is given, given a deal, they are given a bargain, a trade, they're given resources, supplies, things they need in exchange for a child, thus the family giving the child to armed forces. And females are also being used as child soldiers, but not in the sense that they are trained to carry guns. They often do the labor work, they cook, they clean in the encampments, and also used sexually. Right, the source I followed was Child Soldiers International. They made a study and found out because female child soldiers weren't trained like male child soldiers, they weren't seen as child soldiers, they were just seen as females doing labor work, which is common in countries such as Congo and a lot of African countries that traditionally have the women do labor work anyway. And the method that I chose was statistic. According to NCBI, a study was done on 141 child soldiers and 141 regular children, regular being, never been in armed forces, never experienced PTSD, might not be depressed the same way. And the stats show that child soldiers are significantly more depressed and sleep deprived than normal children because of the PTSD and the trauma that they faced being a child soldier. A quote that I found from the NCBI, comparison of mental health between former child soldiers and children never conscripted by armed groups in Nepal, that's just the title, is the dedicated efforts of UNICEF, psychosocial workers, and former child soldiers have called international attention to this issue. The dedicated efforts of UNICEF, psychosocial workers, basically this stood out to me because not only is there an organization meant to help these child soldiers, there are also psychosocial workers and former child soldiers making an effort to help other child soldiers. This is really detrimental because we've all been in a situation that we didn't want to be, but not many of us have thought, okay, let me go back and let me help the other people that have been in the same exact situation. And the fact that former child soldiers are stepping up and trying to help organizations designed for this is really something we have to understand as important and significantly endangering. Another quote that I found was from the Human Rights Watch that says, children also express deep regret that they have lost time they should have spent in school. This stood out to me because I'm sure this is relatable, but nobody really wants to be in school. And the fact that there are children regretting not going to school, saying, oh, I spent so much of my life fighting an unjust cause or forced into fighting when I could have been in school learning, becoming a better person. This also shows the importance of tracking down all child soldiers and helping them out the best way we can. A solution found by, I believe, the NCBI or Child Soldiers International, must be Child Soldiers International, was they recommend find the problem, assess the problem, look at the possibilities, and solve them there. That's just in the most basic sense. They didn't give a breakdown of how to do so. And with the help of other child soldiers, they can find the problem easier and assess it better with people with experience.
Thank you.
So, Jabril, first question. What were the strategies that you used to conduct a review of the literature, and why did you select those strategies? What were the strategies that you used to conduct a review of the literature, and why did you select those strategies?
The strategy I used was mostly what will grasp the attentions, I mean, reader's attention better, because this is more like something you have to feel in order to actually want to read. Like, you can't just say, okay, there are children with guns running around. Like, that's unfortunately common, but this is more like, all right, there's an 8-year-old with an assault rifle fighting in a war. That's something that'll really, like, let me read more about this. This sounds important. So with that mindset, I try to find sources that really emotionally touched me rather than just gave me facts on child soldiers.
Which of the various perspectives that you explored was the most difficult for you to incorporate into your research inquiry? Which of the different perspectives that you explored was the most difficult to incorporate into your research inquiry?
The most difficult must have been my NCBI source, because that was stats and facts. And as mentioned earlier, this is a more touching topic. So having to incorporate stats and percentages into a topic that you really need to, oh, I feel bad for these kids, that was really hard for me.
Final question. Which of your sources was the most influential, and in what way is that influence apparent in your final conclusion?
The most influential must have been the NCBI, no, the Human Rights Watch, because that included quotes from child soldiers, which I probably should have included, but that gave me the most clear perspective of a child soldier, and mostly how child soldiers